Hello, YouTube. I'm back here again doing speed testing. I'm still using my Galaxy Z Fold 3. This time I'm using it for AT&T this go round. Wanted to show you where I'm at. I'm near Eastern Market in Washington, D.C. And the site I'm close to, I'm about 500 yards from the cell site, and this cell band site is using band 2, band 12, band 14, band 30, and band 66. So these are the radio frequencies that's coming off of this cell tower that I'm connected to, and we're going to do some speed testing off of this. Right now it's showing 5G, but I will put it in LTE for the people who not quite sure if the LTE is fast enough for their area. AT&T's 5G is DSS, so it's not going to be as fast as maybe a T-Mobile or a Verizon, but we're going to see the differences on this phone. So let's see. So this is where I am, right here next to the metro station. So we're gonna first do the regular speed test. This is without touching any settings. This is what you get out of the box if you are with AT&T running on the Galaxy Z Fold 3. About 6.87 megabits per second down, and about 20 up from the looks of it. Yep, 20 up. The internet connection is slow for this area, but that's probably because of the DSS. We're going to be able to find that out a little bit later, and then we're going to do a fast. Now, one thing I can say is that AT&T's priority for their network is a lot better than I expected to be. But for the amount you pay for, you're not getting exactly what you pay for in comparison. But right now, that's pretty good. I can stream off of this if I wanted to. About 59 megabits per second, show more. Latency. Alrighty. And imperv. And then start. About 50, max 71, average 33 megabits per second, max 24, average 22. Latency is a little high. Going checking the websites now. Google proficiency was about 74. Facebook is about 73. It's checking Amazon 46. Zoom 48% efficiency. It's fetching the videos now. It should do pretty good with the video right now, due to the fact that that fast.com test was very good. So streaming should not be too much of an issue for this at all. All right, performance rate 91%. 720p was 93%. You're not gonna be able to see the 1080p It's gonna flicker the screen too fast. Alrighty. Some of this got cut off. But let's see. About 71 average for megabits per second down. Browsing on AT&T still not hitting its marks for the amount of money you pay, especially off the elite plan for AT&T. Streaming is very good, but a lot more needs to be desired. Now, what I will do is rerun the imperv test at the same time I do this. So this is the Samsung band selector. Launch this. Go here. Network mode. And only choose all LTE. Now, no 5G. Now let's see what happens when we do this. Come on. So this is just regular LTE for AT&T. Their LTE network is still fast. So DSS 5G is hurting them greatly right now. 300 megabits per second down, and about almost 13, 12.8 up, 41 millisecond ping, about 6 millisecond jitter. And now go back to the imperv test. Now remember, this is what we got on their 5G DSS. Let's see what happens now when you just do regular LTE. Far faster. 278 max, 228 average. 21 max, 19 average. Latency still high. Google, the proficiency is a lot higher when they don't use DSS 5G. From the looks of it. Oh, I called it too fast. That one timed out. Zoom. That one's higher, I think. And the video streaming should be way about on par, about the same. And 720p. And 1080p. So right now, average download speed, 228, max was 278. Browsing on AT&T is still not as good, but their streaming is still about the same. Thank you, YouTube. Come back again for more videos.